My best memory of the couple. Oh, wow. Okay. There's a lot, actually, but it's hard to pick one. I remember the first day I met Rico. I will never forget that because I drove with Brianna or drove to meet them at school. And she's like, "Mom, he's really quiet. Don't ask a whole lot of questions." But she knew that I had played soccer and that was a connection that we could make. So I just really kind of talked about soccer. But that was the first time I had ever met him. And that was really good. It wasn't awkward. At least I didn't think it was. So it obviously worked out. When did I know they would get married? It was probably a couple years into their relationship. I knew for sure that they would. But the more time I spent with them as a couple, when they'd come for dinner or things like that, you could just tell there was really something there. There was really something special. So I would say for sure, probably within year three at the, you know, that was like, it was really settled. They're my kids. I'm excited. So, because I think, with Rico's parents not being here, I kind of really, had a really soft spot in my heart for him, because I know how it can be being away from your family, being long distance. There's no way that it was long distance for me. I spent some time away from my parents, about 1,000 miles away from my parents, but his was like 6,000 miles. So I know what that's like not to have parents close by. So that just was, I think, what kind of got us a special, little bit of a special bond there between he and I. But they're just, I don't know. It's hard to put that into words. I don't think she ever actually said the words that she loved him, but I just knew. I knew watching them that, and then it was just talking about what we talked about what we would do in our future and things like that. But I don't think she probably told her sister, but I don't think she ever told me that she had said that she had loved him until I actually asked. I wish you lots of love, lots of special moments, lots of tender moments, lots of good times, lots of laughs. There will be tears, but just communication and staying close to each other and talking and just being there for each other in the good times and the bad. Just wish you all the love in the world.
The best memory that I can remember is when Brianna traveled to Saipan with Enrico. It's it's different part of the world, and it's I know it's really a long travel, but you know, Brianna was able to spend time with us and meet the whole family, and she was able to experience island life, the culture, and Rico's hometown, and you know, I think that's really memorable one.
Well, I second that. For me, throughout the relationship, I know they've been together for like years now, but the one that really hits me the most is when she took the effort to explore and decided to go with him when he flew back to Saipan for a vacation. It was scary at first, you know, for her. I'm pretty sure. I mean, I think it's like about 30 hours flight, and it's like 7,500 miles. And so just for her to drop whatever she's having in here, take the chance, and you know, I mean, I take the risk and fly, you know, flew with him just to meet us, to see where he's from, to see where he grew up, and you know, meet the people that are close to him. I think that's something that is not just sweet and all, but brave. So for that, I'm really thankful, and that she actually took the chance to take that step. the time that he brought him, the time that he brought her to our place. I mean, because we're Asians, right? So we don't really introduce someone to the family unless it's really, really, unless you're decided, you've decided that he or she is the one. So the, with my son telling us that time that they're flying back to Saipan and, you know, should be finally meeting us. It's not just over the phone or, you know, video call and all. And then on top of that, after a few weeks, her mom and grandma decided to come to and meet us. I was like, this is it. This is it. So from then on, I know they are getting married. They are ending up together.
I think I knew that, you know, they're in love when, you know, Enrico always talks about her, you know, talks about how she makes him happy and how she supported his you know, like, soccer career, because, you know, Enrico's, you know, really focused in, you know, in the things that he do, and sports is one of them. And for someone to really understand and support and do sacrifices, because, you know, back in those times, Enrico travels a lot because of tournaments, and Brianna's always been supportive and, you know, like, very, like, really into it. So I knew from that moment that she's really the one, that, you know, perfect match for Enrico, because they understand, you know, in the beginning they already understand each other. So basically, moving forward, or, you know, in the future, they already knew what are the, you know, yeah, what's in store for them. Yeah.
It may be too cliche, or, you know, of course, we wish you all the happiness, all the love. We're just here. We always tell you guys that whatever happens, our love and dedications and support and everything basically are always with you guys. We're just here whenever you guys need us. We will not try to meddle to whatever you guys would have. So that I can assure you. But in case that you need us, we're here. We're always available. Always love each other. Communication is the key. Always talk to each other. I mean, nothing could never be resolved if you never talk to each other. So you gotta understand that each of you, I mean, no one is a mind reader, okay? So you have to speak up when you are not, how do I say it? I mean, be honest to each other. Don't keep it to yourself until you reach the point that you're about to give up or whatever. Don't ever reach that point. Always communicate, and everything will be resolved or whatever. I mean, I'm sorry, not whatever, but everything will be resolved and everything would be okay.
My only wish for Brianna and Enrico is that be that light during the dark times. And, you know, I think that says everything. And, you know, patience is very important. And, you know, love each other unconditionally. And, you know, whatever happens, you have to make it work. As, like, you know, we, like, me and my wife had our vows, you know, our marriage, and it says there, you know, you two promise to each other that you will be there to thickness and in health. So I guess, you know, that's my wish for you two. Just love each other, and, you know, best wishes. We love you guys.
Oh, this is a good one. I knew they got married when I came over here, and then I saw them look at each other. You know, like in a Toy Story movie when it just happens? The moment, you just see the moment, it's like over. It was there. I'm excited for the future a lot, because they complement each other very well. Rico is a very calm person. I can't say the same thing about Brie, but without a doubt, I think they're they complement each other very well. Nothing but love. You guys are awesome. I can see it. Hopefully everyone else can see it, but I see it.
Just because, like, just the way that he looks at her, like, you can tell there is a lot of love there. She just always is so happy every time she's talking about him. I really just feel like they've really pushed each other to be the best versions of themselves, and I think they're gonna continue to do that. Bree, we met at Steak and Shake in our little bow ties. That turned out to be like a really great thing because we ended up figuring out we were going to college together. And then we ended up going to a party together, and lo and behold, there was Enrico, and that's when they kind of met. And yeah, so just kind of saw everything fall into place from there. I wish you two nothing but love and happiness your entire lifetime. I hope you two fulfill all of the dreams that you have for one another, and that life is just happy.
Any of the years on vacation when all the cousins would get together and we play Pictionary or something like that, you could just see them both together, you know, smiling, having fun and stuff like that. You could see that they both really truly enjoyed each other, and I could see that, you know, Rico treated my cousin good, which was also nice. I'm excited about their future, probably for the same reason, because I see that Rico treats my cousin with respect and truly cares about her, and that's the most thing I care about out of everything. So I might be the youngest, but I still love her. Probably when Brianna got energetic almost about talking about him. She's like me. She's a very anxious, conceited person where she likes to keep a lot to herself, but she became very open about him after a long time talking about him. So I realized that she actually truly cared about him after that, and that they had a chance. So it was nice. I hope that I get to see you guys continually like I have over the past few years for the rest of our lives, and I hope that Rico treats her great.
My best memory with the couple was we were at Newport on the levee, and we were just hanging out, and they gave me some really good dating advice, and we just sat on the, I think it was dating advice, I don't know, we talked a bunch, and we were sitting on like by the riverside, and it was great just to talk about life and stuff, and it just shows how human we are and that we go through the same thing. So yeah, why am I excited for the future is they're both incredible people, so pair them up, that's, you know, that's exciting.
Best memory of the couple. Unfortunately, I have not been able to meet Brianna till tonight, but just seeing Rico on social media and how happy they looked over the years and how much they've grown together is probably so far the best memory. Many more to be made.
See, this way you messed up. You set me up for this. Because, you know, Saipan got a lot of white girls in the island. She walked through. See, I don't know whether I'm funny or being serious. Because she walked into practice at the new stadium. She walked into practice, and I saw a white girl walking in. I goes, "Who'd I go?" He goes, "That's Rico's girl." He goes, "Okay." Never mind. Yeah, bro.
She was excited.
Yeah, she awesome. Was. I didn't know, bro. She walked in. I go, story. "Who that white girl, bro?" He goes, "That's Rico's girl." I goes, "Damn."
They just always looked happy.
Cause I know Rico a bit deeper, sentimental. He never had a girlfriend in Saipan.
Yeah.
He never had a girlfriend. And I know he liked somebody X, Y, and Z. But when I saw her and with him together, you look into somebody's eyes.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, that's my girl. Like, that's your safe zone. And we ended up practice one day and she was walking behind. And we had a fucking terrible practice with fucking running. And he looked into her eye, and that's my safe zone, bro. I knew. Like, I've done that with some girls and stuff like that. like when you run, like you have a bad day at work, X, Y, and Z, and you saw that person you love, you go home, and he saw her, bro, he was smiling, and it was,
I hate that I was so older than you guys.
Like, and I saw that in his eye, bro, like, same way you see, so, like, I'm like, damn, that's where equals go.
Rico's a phenomenal guy, and Bri seems like a phenomenal person. And, I mean, the dude has come across the globe to go to school and just create a better life for himself. Not that the life on Saipan was bad, it's great. But just have more opportunity out here, and man, I'm excited to see where they go.
Lucas is a lovely guy. He knows what he sees somebody he loves, and Lucas speaks about love, and I believe Lucas. I know nothing about love. I don't know anything about love. That's not my category, and Lucas said they're good, and they're good.
A long, happy, joyful life, many trips around the world, and Rico, you're going to have to start deer hunting.
I know Rico can't fucking shoot, so he can't deer hunt. We can sit together while we watch Lucas deer hunting, like in a few months. I know Rico and I can't shoot for shit.
No, yeah. We'll
be there. The same way as the hike you took us to. That was fucking terrible. Me and Rico look at you like, why the fuck did we come here? We gotta cancel. No, I'm just kidding. You know, good experience. But yeah, no. They're good together. We're gonna be together. What's I don't know the fuck question
was. Speak English, bro.
I know, blah, blah, blah.
Advice for them.
Oh, advice for them. I ain't know anything about relationships. I don't really know.
All right, just give them a kiss. Blow a kiss.
I love you guys.
Love you, brother.